the communications director from the Michigan High School Athletic Association. A big announcement this week. They've made a decision to try and involve more of the Class C schools in football by lowering the number of players on the field. And that's John Johnson from the Michigan High School Athletic Association. What are you doing over there? Hi, John. How are you?
Hey guys, we're doing well.
Hey,
well,
good welcome to hear your voice, John.
Welcome yeah. to WTKA with us. We're glad to be back here. We're looking forward to bringing our high school broadcast here in the fall. So hope you'll be part of that.
Yeah, we're pleased to be with you here in the new digs, and it is an exciting time because schools in certain parts of the state, in particular, of Class D size have been struggling to field football teams of late. You think about the Upper Peninsula, the Thumb, it's an issue, a little bit in southwest Michigan. And so during the winter, you know, some exploration began about formats for football with fewer than 11 players. And, of course, at the high school level, you've got formats for six-man and seven and eight and nine-man.
Right.
And so after several months of study, the association put together a plan, which its representative council, its governing board, approved later this month. That if for the 2010 season, if more than 20 schools or 20 or more schools will commit to playing eight-man football, then we'll have that as a separate division of our playoffs that fall.
Just be called an eight-man division.
Yeah, it would be eight-man football, eight-player football, you know, whatever term you want to use for it. But it's eight players. It's probably the most popular sub-11-man format that's written. It's played in more states.
Right.
Texas, it's the six-man game is incredibly popular. And, you know, you guys will identify with this, and I know I'll show my age when I say that Earl Campbell,
sure,
came yeah. from a six-man football program in high school.
Right.
Now,
he went on to collegiate and professional stardom.
What do these schools do now, for the most part, that are being targeted? Do they not have a team, or do they have a team, but they're just real thin?
Well, that's the issue. The teams are thin. They struggle year in and year out to be viable. And some have just said, we can't go on playing the 11-player game. And probably the one of that group with the most backbone and the most vocal about it is Carsonville-Port Sanilac up north
sure.
of Port Huron.
Yep.
And they said they wanted to go six-man. And finally, when everybody said no, the eight-man game seems to be favored, they said, "Well, fine, we'll play the eight-man game. We'll play it starting this fall." And they've got a seven-game schedule, and they're going to go across the bridge on opening weekend. You know, about 3 months from right now, and play Engadine, which is a school of even smaller enrollment.
Oh my
Port Sanilac has about 150 kids. Engadine has about 100.
Yep.
And Engadine's giving up one of its 11-man football dates to play an eight-player game this year with Carsonville-Port Sanilac.
Well, it's a whole interesting new area for fans and for media to follow, because it's going to look different. You're going to have it's going to be, the pace of the game will be different, I'm sure. The field is more narrow. It's 40 yards wide versus 53.5, but it's still 100 yards long, so it's still going to be football, but it's just a little bit different.
It's a little bit different. Drop a couple of linemen off the line, take away a running back, and, you know, it looks like kind of like old intramural football or Air Force football,
right,
you know.
Right.
Everybody's running all over the place. The pace is furious. The scores are high. And, you know, I've watched films of the eight-man game from out in Kansas and out in Iowa, where in Iowa it's grown incredibly. They just had 20-some-odd schools just a few years ago. They've got nearly 70 now. And so for those small schools, which have been struggling to maintain viable numbers for their football programs, you know, we think that this will help keep that Friday night spirit experience alive. And the other side of that coin is that we've got an awful lot of schools out there now that are charter schools or small faith-based schools
right.
that struggle to offer programs, athletics, period. And they might see eight-man football as a way to get into football and make themselves more attractive in the community. And so I think we'll see, you know, a little bit of everything. We'll see some schools drop the 11-man game in favor of the 8-man game. We'll see some schools revive football because of the eight-man game, and we'll see some new schools come on the scene with the football game.
And we might see the disappearance of those varsity teams that have 14, 15, 16 players.
Well, and I think that's important, too, because, you know, when does that become a dangerous experience for those kids? And when you've got an 11-man team and, you know, you look over at the bench and almost everybody's in street clothes, you know, they outnumber the players, you know, that's a pretty dangerous situation, particularly in a school where those four or five substitutes might be freshmen and sophomores. Well, and they're playing an 11-man game and they're overmatched.
It's nice to see the Athletic Association respond to the needs of the schools, too. I always love to see that because it's all about the kids.
It's not about
the schools. It's not about the coaches, the ADs. It's about the kids. And this addresses the kid situation.
Now, do you have to be a Class D school to qualify for this?
Yeah, Class D school. The Class D enrollment limit will be the limit for those teams that want to play in the tournament.
Okay.
We have had some calls we've had some interest from the PSL saying, hey, we're struggling with numbers in some of our programs. Could we have eight-man football? And the answer, of course, to that is yes, you just wouldn't have a playoff.
Sure.
And in fact, the Catholic League in the Detroit area, probably as recent as 10 years ago or so, was playing eight-man football at the sub-varsity level just because of numbers there. And so, you know, what it does is, you know, it gives schools a vision for, you know, some flexibility to be able to offer either eight-man or 11-man. And, of course, the school will have to declare which one they're going to be for the tournament if they're in Class D. But, you know, I think it's this kind of thinking that, you know, is pointed towards giving kids this opportunity to play, which has gotten us where we're at.
Well, John Johnson, thanks for joining us tonight. Let's talk more as the summer rolls on. We want to hear more about how the scheduling situation is going with the high schools with the big change in the last year or so. And we hope you'll use us as your one of your outlets here in Ann Arbor for all the high school news.
Well, good. It's good to hear from you guys again. We look forward to that.
Okay, John Johnson.
Thanks,
talk to you soon.
Have a good weekend.
You too. Have a great holiday. We'll take a break. We'll come back. We got a little baseball to talk before we end up this big show here on a Friday on Sports Talk 1050 WTKA.